Do you want to know which SNAP PDUs exist and how they can be used? My name is Icopras and I will discuss in this tutorial which operations SNAP managers can perform upon SNAP agents. Such operations are called protocol data units, or in short PDUs, and allow managers to read and modify the managed objects within SNAP agents. Note that this video is the short version of our tutorial on SNAP PDUs. There is also an extended version, including many examples as well as PDU error handling. An initial version of these PDUs was defined by RFC 1157 as part of the SNAP version 1 standards, which are now historic. An improved version of these PDUs was redefined later as part of the second version of the SNAP standards. Since both versions are widely used, this tutorial discusses both versions as well as their differences. Note that the latest version of SNAP, thus version 3, did add security but made no changes to the PDU definitions. Let's start with identifying which PDUs exist. The first PDU is the GET PDU, which is used by the manager to read information contained within agents. The SET PDU is used by the manager to modify information within the agent. Like the GET PDU, the GET NEXT PDU is used to read agent information. As opposed to the GET PDU, for a GET NEXT, the manager does not need to know the precise identifier of the managed object. The GET NEXT is therefore ideal for discovering which MIP objects the agent supports and to retrieve dynamic information, such as tables that dynamically change their size. The GET BULK PDU was introduced as part of the SNAP v2 communications model and is ideal for retrieving large amounts of data. With TRAPS, agents have an opportunity to signal special events to the manager. The manager will not acknowledge reception of the TRAP, which means that the agent cannot be sure that the manager received the TRAP. Therefore, version 2 of the SNAP standard added the Inform PDU, which serves similar purposes as the TRAP PDU, but which is acknowledged by the manager. Finally, there is a Report PDU, which is internally used by the SNAP protocol to signal protocol exceptions or errors, but will never be directly used by management applications. Except for the Report PDU, in this tutorial we will discuss these PDUs in detail. First, we will discuss the GET REQUEST PDU, which is sent by the manager to the agent to request the value of one or more managed objects. Within the request, the manager specifies the identifiers of the objects the manager is interested in. In this example, the manager wants to know the value of the triangle object. After reception of the GET request, the agent determines the value of the triangle object and sends this value together with the object identifier back to the manager. The combination of object identifier and object value is called a variable binding, or in short, varbind. The next PDU we will discuss is the SET PDU. This PDU is used by the manager to set or modify the value of one or more managed objects. In our example, the manager wants to modify the value of the triangle object. Since communication between manager and agent is based on UDP and therefore unreliable, the agent will always send back a response with the varbind included to signal the request was successful or failed. Note that the SET operation cannot only be used to modify object values, but may also trigger certain actions, like disabling an interface or rebooting a device. Instead of modifying static objects, the SET can also be used to instantiate new table objects. The addition of a new row to a table is a relatively complex operation which involves usage of row status. Note that row status textual convention was explained in the SMI video tutorial. In this video, we will not discuss the details of adding table rows. In the previous example, the set request was used to modify the value of a single object. However, the set request may also be used to modify multiple objects at once. In such case, the setPDU will contain multiple var binds. An important property of the set operation is that it is atomic. Either all objects are modified or none. Although this sounds like a nice property, implementing atomic operations is very hard, especially if extensible agent technology is used. An important addition that was introduced with SNMP version 2 is the description of the set operation as a conceptual two-phase commit. In the first phase, the agent checks if all objects specified in the request can indeed be modified. If this is the case, phase 2 is entered and the actual modifications are performed. If the checks within phase 1 are not passed, a rollback will be performed. In case of the getPDU introduced before, the manager needs to include the exact identifier of the object of which the value should be retrieved. But what to do if the manager does not know the precise identifier of the object? There are two cases in which this is common. The first case is where the manager wants to inspect or browse which MIP objects are supported by a certain agent. The second case is where the manager wants to retrieve the value of table entries. Note that table entries can be indexed by identifiers that change in runtime, such as IP addresses in case of routing tables. Since the manager cannot know such indexes in advance, getPDUs would not be usable. The getNextPDU was defined to handle these cases. As part of the getNext request, the manager sends the identifier of the object that precedes the object the manager is interested in. In our example, the manager wants to know the value of the second object within the table. The manager therefore sends a getNext request that carries the object identifier of the preceding object, thus the first object of the table. After reception of the request, the agent determines the successor of the first table object. Since tables are ordered column by column, the successor of the first object within the first column will be the second object within the first column. The agent will retrieve the value of the second object and send its value back to the manager together with its identifier. The manager now knows the identifier of the second table object and can use this identifier to retrieve the value of the third table object via a subsequent getNext request. Upon reception of this new getNext request, the agent will determine the identifier and value of the third object and send this back as varbind in responsePDU. The manager can use the returned object identifier for a subsequent getNext, etc. After the last element of the first column has been retrieved, the next one will be the first element of the second column. In this way, all table objects can be queried. However, if we want to retrieve all table entries, a much better approach is to query the table row by row. This can be done by specifying in the getNext request not a single object identifier, but all object identifiers that belong to a given row. The getNextPDU that we discussed before allowed us to retrieve the value and identifier of the next table object. But what if we need to know the next three objects? With the getNext, we would need three interactions between manager and agent, which would take quite some time. Therefore, SNMP version 2 introduced the getBulk PDU, which allows us to retrieve more than one next object in a single interaction. In the example, we show a getBulk requesting the next three objects. The request carries the identifier of the first object and specifies 3 for the value of the max repetitions parameter. After reception of the request, the agent identifies the values and identifiers of the next 3 objects and sends these back in the response to the manager. By means of the max repetition parameter, getBulk can not only behave as a series of consecutive getNext operations, but an additional parameter called non-repeaters can also make getBulk to act as a single getNext operation. The value of non-repeaters indicates how many of the var binds in the request PDU will be treated as a single getNext. The remaining var binds will be treated as a series of consecutive getNext. Assume that the request includes 2 var binds and the values for non-repeaters is 1 and max repetition is 3. After the request is received by the agent determines the value of the object that lexicographically follows the non-repeaters var bind, as well as the 3 values following the max repetition var bind. These values are then returned to the manager as part of the response PDU. In practice, non-repeaters is often used to retrieve the value of sysup times, whereas max repetition is used to retrieve a series of table elements. The trap was defined in SNMP version 1 to allow agents to signal special events to the manager. Examples of such events include a cold start of the agent, which may have the effect that all MIP variables have new values, a warm start, which differs from the cold start in the sense that variables have kept their old values, a link up or link down event, which includes the index of the interface that has changed, an authentication failure, or an enterprise-specific event. It should be noted that reception of the trap is not confirmed by the manager. The trap mechanism is therefore unreliable and the manager should continue polling the agents to check if special events occurred. Agents may be configured such that no traps will be transmitted or that traps will only be transmitted to specific managers. Since traps were quite limited, the SNMP version 2 standard completely redefined the operation of the trap PDU to make it more flexible. Possible events were no longer defined as part of the protocol operations, but could now be defined as part of MIP modules. The SNMI V2 introduced for that purpose so-called notification type macros. Since events are now defined as part of MIP module definitions instead of the SNMP protocol itself, new events can now be defined and added where needed. Trap usage has therefore become much more flexible. With SNMP version 2, also the encoding of the trap PDU has changed and is now the same as the other PDUs. This means that software can be simplified. Since the manager does not acknowledge reception of the trap PDU and SNMP uses the unreliable UDP transport protocol to send its PDUs, the agent cannot be sure if the trap was received by the manager. Therefore, version 2 of the SNMP protocol standard added the inform PDU, which, like the SNMP V2 trap PDU, is able to send notifications to the manager. However, as opposed to the trap PDU, after reception of the inform PDU, the manager sends an acknowledgement back to the agent in the form of response PDU. In this tutorial, we have discussed the PDUs that are defined and used by SNMP version 1, version 2, and version 3. We have discussed the get PDU, which is used by the manager to retrieve the values for static ORDs that the manager knows. The getNext PDU, which is used to retrieve tables and discover which MIP modules are supported by a certain agent. The GetBulk PDU, which was added with SNAP v2 and is able to retrieve entire tables within a single interaction. The SetPDU, which is used by the manager to change object values or add new elements to a table. The TrapPDU, which is sent by the agent to the manager to signal occurrence of special events. The InformPDU, which was added by SNAP version 2 and allows traps to be confirmed. I hope you enjoyed this video and take a look at our other SNAP tutorials as well.